Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel and I hope you're doing great today. And okay, in this video I will show you how to make an API call with simple code in Swiss file. And let's go ahead and create together. And the first thing you need to do is create a new single view application. As you can see in this demo, I'm using the single view application. This is empty application, so we're getting started on Visual Controller right here. So you need to have an API URL to make a request. So I already have the API request already, so let's get started together. In Swiss, you can using the URL system to make an API call to get any data from the API. So you can say create an URL and equal to URL string, and right here you need to paste the URL string right here. Okay, and after that I just want to create a URL task, and we can use URL session. Yeah, session dot share and dot data task. Okay, right here what you need to use is request with completion handler, and I need to put my URL right here. Next to that, we need to use describer. Okay, and what you need to do next is okay, we need an optional. You can unwrite this optional. So what you need to do next is you need to use test.resume. Sorry, resume write this. So now this URL session will request to your URL. So let me paste my URL. Okay, here is my URL. That is my local URL that I just run my local server to test with the API. So you can paste your URL with public API or your local API as well. So let's test it out. And what you need to do next is create an decode. In this tutorial I will use decode JSON decoder to decode data into object. So what you need to do is I will show my JSON data. Okay, here is my JSON data. So I need to create an object decoder to map with my API response. So I need to create below this code. Okay, what you need to do is create a structure. I can say my book, and I need to confirm my callable. Okay, right here, and what you need to do is create an object ID, title, and the link right here. So I need an object ID. And data type is integer, and another two object another two prompts is Tara and Blink. And the data type is string. Okay, it's simple, right? So now we have a codeable object. So we get back to our API response right here. So what we need to do is check this out. If let data equal true data right here. So in here it means data is not near. So I can create a book list response equal to try JSON decoder right here. JSON decoder object, and you need to just function decode from what you put here is an book object, and the book object is an array, as you can see in the JSON response right here. It is an array. So what you need to do is create an array, and from where? From data response. Okay, now we got an book list response, and what we need to do is going down and just print it to make sure it will book response. Okay, let's be a run to see the result. Okay, let's check it out. Okay, we got an error. So as you can see, we got an error at transport security was blocked. Create a check HTTP. So what you need to do to fix this error, let's go ahead to fix together. And you can stop this application. And what you need to do is go into the plist. You need to config and key in the plist. So all right, so let's go to the plist right here and open it as the source code, and after that you need to put key. You can say key and s up trying smart. If you want to add an easy way, you can open it as a property list. Okay, and you press, click on the plus like this, and you can type ns app transport security. Okay, that's part of security setting. And after that, we need to put an element allow attribute log, as you can see right here. And set it to yes. Okay, right. So now let's get started to run the game. Here we go now. The error is gone and our data is printed out. Here it is. Okay, not pretty nice. You can say first element took time. Has been done together again. Okay, as you can see, it's the first element is book 1, Itaro. And you can check in over here, right here. Okay, I think you understand what I'm doing. So you can add some error handling by using, you can check error, virtual error, to make sure it nothing error. Okay, and return. Okay, and you can check any response code by using that. Grab.xdbg response. Record your response as dbg response code number. Name from the to this code to this code as name that contain an element HTTP which is the last dot status code. Alright. As you can see, you can have the response as well. Okay, thank you for watching, and I hope you like this video. And the next video, we will integrate this API into application that can store PDF list and can view PDF from your API. So comment below if you have any question, and don't forget to subscribe and share. See you in the next video. Thank you.